Do you ever wonder why it's completely normal to feed pet snakes, mice, and rats whole prey, but it isn't normal for us to feed our pet cats whole prey, mice, and rats? Why is that? I don't really understand. This is something that I've been thinking about. It's just so normal for people who have reptiles. Well, snakes are carnivores. They eat whole prey mice and rats in the wild. Therefore, pet snakes should also eat the same diet. Cats are carnivores, and feral cats eat whole prey mice, rabbits, small birds, rats, etc. But pet cats, they need a different diet, apparently. So why is it normal for pet snakes but not for pet cats? I would love to know what you think in the comments below. Hello, my friend. It is Jess and my boss, Jericho. It is a blessing that you are here. Hallelujah. So first, let's talk about how many people have pet snakes versus pet cats, because there is a big difference. So according to the AVMA's 2022 Pet Ownership and Demographic Sourcebook, 26% of households have pet cats, versus 1.4% households having pet reptiles. So very, very big difference. Lots more pet cats than there are pet snakes. But apparently there were over 333 million people living in the US in 2022. So if we take those percentages, we have roughly 86.6 million people who have pet cats and over 4.6 million people who have pet reptiles. So fewer people have pet snakes or pet reptiles, including snakes, but that's still a lot of people, 4.6 million people who are feeding pet snakes an appropriate diet, aka whole prey. So I use AVMA specifically because we're going to take a look at two different articles from AVMA. And the first one is Selecting a Pet Reptile, straight from AVMA. So first they talk about what makes reptiles special, and they mention things like they need a proper environment, they have an interesting appearance and different colors. And it also says that they are excellent at adapting to different environments. It also says that you will only have to feed your pet snake like once a week, which can be convenient if you are traveling. I have a friend, he has a pet snake, he feeds a mouse like once a week. I mean, could you imagine that? Just eating once a week and then being fine? That would be save me lots of time in the kitchen. So then it says, what do reptiles eat? It says, quote, "Make sure you are able to feed the reptile you select an appropriate diet. For example, you should not get a carnivorous snake if you know you will not be comfortable feeding it meat such as mice or rats." Now, isn't that interesting? Very normal, straight to the point, and blasé. If you cannot handle feeding meat like mice and rats, do not get a carnivorous snake. Straight from the AVMA. I find that very, very interesting and fascinating because it's to the point. They're carnivores. They need to eat meat like mice and rats. Don't get one if you are not comfortable feeding that to your pet snake because that is their species appropriate diet. So let's see what they say about selecting a pet cat. The AVMA has a very similar beginning to reptiles. So they point out what makes cats special, and it has things like entertaining antics, affectionate behavior, easier to house train, and relatively low maintenance. Feeding is mentioned in the special needs section, but it isn't as upfront as it is with reptiles. Again, I wonder why. I don't know. I am happy though that they talk about the importance of exercise and play and keeping a clean litter box. Absolutely, those are all important for cats. But then it just says cats need high quality food. Well, what does that mean? What is high quality food, right? Like, it isn't as specific as reptiles. Like, they need meat such as mice and rats. Like, they give you what they need to eat generally because they're carnivores, and then they give you specific examples. With cats, well, they need high quality food. I mean, that's pretty subjective because what one person thinks is high quality is different than other people. So there's really no mention of a specific diet or that they are even carnivores on this AVMA article selecting a pet cat. They go into a lot of detail about other things, but not really about diet. So again, it's like, why is it normal for pet snakes, but not for pet cats? It's just, it's very interesting to me that they would go into detail and be specific for snakes, but not necessarily for cats. So VCA Hospitals is another big organization. You know, if you're searching for things about your cat, I'm sure you've come across their website. They also have two different guides, one feeding pet snakes and one feeding your cat well. So let's see what they say about this. So for VCA Hospital, I love this. They waste no time for snakes. The very first heading, what do snakes eat? All snakes are carnivores. Some eat warm-blooded prey, e.g. rodents, rabbits, birds, while others eat insects, amphibians, eggs, other reptiles, etc. So again, very normal, straight to the point, very blasé, like point of fact. They are carnivores. Most of them eat whole prey. You need to feed mice. And then they give examples again. So you have rodents, rabbits, birds, etc. So very simple, very straightforward. That's the first thing they talk about. Let's see if we get simple and straightforward for cats. Jericho's like, I don't know what to do with myself. You're not feeding me, so I don't know. So the beginning is a bit more general, but they do mention that nutrition is important. You know, at least they're mentioning it. Next, they talk about veterinary nutrition, how it's exploded and benefited our cats. They explain the differences between feeding kittens, adult cats, and seniors. They talk a lot about AFCO nutritional guidelines and the feeding trials. VCA Hospitals also recommends to partner with your veterinarian to choose an appropriate food for your cat. And another part that I'm happy that they mention is to monitor your cat's body condition score, weight, how much you're feeding, and what is recommended to feed. So they give good guidelines on that. But at this point, there's still no mention that cats are carnivores and what diet is best for them. Next, they talk more about AFCO. They also state it is crucial to understand that cats cannot be fed a vegetarian diet. Cats are obligate carnivores, and their nutrient profile must contain a meat-sourced protein. And again, they suggest working with your cat's veterinarian to choose that appropriate diet. So they take it a little step further and say obligate carnivore, which means they are restricted to, it is mandatory that cats eat a carnivore diet, so a meat-based diet. And they say, you know, it must contain a meat-sourced protein. They do suggest feeding portion meals at scheduled mealtimes. Again, I agree with that as well. Free feeding is just going to make your cat overeat, especially when there is carbohydrates and tasty cat food. They say, cat foods today are very tasty and very calorie dense, which means a little goes a long way. Well, isn't that a nice way of saying that pet food is filled with carbohydrates that fuel hunger and weight gain, and on top of that, they are sprayed with pet food flavor enhancer palatants so that your cat actually eats it, but then your cat gets addicted to it and overeats and then becomes overweight. It's just so much easier to say, well, cat food is tasty, so, you know, just make sure you don't overfeed your cat. So interesting. So we have two different establishments saying point blank, snakes are carnivores, they eat whole prey, mice and rats, rodents, rabbits. Don't get a carnivore snake if you can't handle feeding that. But then for cats, I mean, AVMA didn't even acknowledge that cats are carnivores. They did say nutrition is important, they need high quality food, but what does that actually mean? VCA Hospital says that they are obligate carnivores, they need meat-based protein, but then they just talk about cat food generally. Here's what AFCO does, partner with your vet. It isn't very specific. So why is it, again, why is it normal for pet snakes who are carnivores, their wild counterparts eat whole prey, therefore pets, indoor snakes, will also eat whole prey. Feral cats, same species that we have here, the only difference is their physical location. It's not the same. It's not so black and white. It's not so point blank and blasé. You know, it isn't normal for cats to eat their natural species appropriate diet, even though they are obligate carnivores. And I think it's very interesting with the AVMA because they go into great detail to make sure that you're prepared before you adopt a cat. Things like making sure your landlord approves it, making sure you have the space for it, making sure you have the time to dedicate to keeping the litter box clean, to socialization. They talk about how to raise a kitten. They talk about selecting breeds. But then they don't say anything about diet. And they're just very straightforward with pet snakes. They're like, don't even bother getting a pet snake if you can't handle feeding mice and rats. But then they don't have the same, you know, disclaimer for cats. Very, very interesting. So, and I do agree with everything again, like clean litter box. Yes, that's important. Bye-bye, Jericho. He's like, I don't care if you're filming. But I do agree with, you know, again, like I said, portion meals at scheduled mealtimes. Yes. Keeping track of your cat's body condition score, his weight, how much you're feeding, and keeping a clean litter box. Of course, I talk about all of those things on this channel. That's very important. But something as important as diet, nutrition, and they even say that high quality food. It's like, okay, well, give us an example. Give us some specifics. You know, if it's that easy and point blank and simple for pet snakes, why not pet cats? I don't know. Something that I've been thinking about. I think it's very interesting, especially reading these articles. It's like, you know, why is it normal for one carnivore but not normal for another carnivore? I would love to know what you think in the description. I'm feeding Jericho whole prey. I love it. He loves it. It's great. It's so easy. Just, I really like it. If you want to feed whole prey too, you can switch your cat to raw first. That'll make the transition much easier. If you're feeding dry or wet canned food, like processed food, check my Switch to Raw Blueprint course in the description. But other than that, I would love to know your thoughts in the comments. Let me know how you're seeing this. Thanks so much for being here, and I appreciate you watching.